Hey guys, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you the brand new Face Aware Liquify tool. Hey Cafe crew, how's it going? You're gonna love this new feature. It's a heck of a lot of fun. It's the Face Aware Liquify. Now you've got a couple of options. You can use this sensibly, you know, and be mature and use it as a retouching tool to, you know, make eyes a little bit bigger and just do little enhancements. Or you can go over the edge and go a little bit crazy and do caricatures and kind of crazy things. Of course, because here at Photoshop Cafe, we love to always just keep things just, you know, down low, very, you know, low key. Of course, we're gonna go over the edge and have some fun with this. So I know you're gonna love it because I'm loving this. It's a ton of fun. So let's get started. All right, this feature here is a lot of fun. This is the Face Aware Liquify, and I know you're gonna love it. So what I'm gonna do is I've got this picture here from Adobe Stock of a woman, and I'm gonna make her look a little bit more like Taylor Swift. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go under the filter, and then we're gonna choose the Liquify. And there we go. So the Face Aware, you'll notice it shows the face there, and right here it's showing the face has actually been detected and all the different parts. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a little bit of fun with this one, and then I've got another image I'm going to show you with some celebrity presets. Now remember, these are not going to look exactly like these celebrities because other things have to happen, you know, certain facial features, eyebrows and different things like that. But anyway, let's have a look at what we can do here. So here we go, we've got the eye size, and I know that Taylor Swift has smaller eyes, so we're going to make those a little smaller. Notice we can change the size of those. She also has wider eyes, so let's make these a little wider. And drop the height down a little bit. There we go. So we're going to drop the size down a little bit more. All right, so let's have a look at the tilt. This is pretty amazing. Check this out. So we can go like this way, or we can go like that. And notice when we start to get a little bit more this way, it's more the Taylor Swift cat eyes. But her eyes are a little bit closer to each other, so let's change the distance. Notice this, we can go like that, or we can go way out like that. So we can get kind of carried away with this. I'm thinking about here is about right. So this is the a good start here. So now let's move down to the nose. So there's two things we can change on the nose, is we can make the nose narrow or we can make it wide. Now, of course, you know, you can have some fun with this with your friends. Well, Taylor has a slightly narrower nose, so let's go for that. And also the distance here between the nose and the lips is a little bit shorter for her. So we can do that. Notice we can move the nose up or down. So I'm going to bring it to about there. And then we've got the lips. Now, this is my fun part. Watch this, the smile. Hey! yeah, so you can look very miserable, pouty, or you can make them look very happy. Although, it looks, usually when the mouth is open, the smile looks a little bit more believable. So we'll just give a little bit of a smile so she's not too miserable. And then what we're going to do is we're going to make the mouth width narrower, because I know that Taylor has a smaller mouth, and we're also going to make the height a bit smaller. See how we can change the size of the mouth, and we can also change the lips. So we can make the upper lip really big, like they just, you know, put Botox or whatever it is they inject into their lips. It's not Botox, but something. So we'll make that just a little bit smaller, and in the lower lip, we can make it smaller or bigger. So this is actually working not bad, considering we've even got a hand covering this. In the next example, we won't. So this is a difficult one to work with. So we've got there. Okay, let's move up to the next part, the forehead. So we can bring the forehead nice and close, or we can make it a larger forehead. See that? So I'm going to make the forehead smaller. And then the chin height. So we can make it a long chin, or we can make it a shorter chin. So I'm going to go to about there, because it's actually kind of similar to what Taylor Swift's chin would be there. Then the face width. So I know she definitely has a narrower face than this. So we can change the width of the face. Look at this. We can make it skinny, or we can make it a wider face. So you can see this is like super fun. So we can go right there. And in the jawline, do you want a thinner jaw or do you want a wider jaw? Let's go for a slightly thinner jaw. Alright, so there we go. So we've made some adjustments there. I'm going to make the eyes just a little bit smaller though, because those eyes feel a little big. And also the width. Let's just bring the eye distance together just a little bit more. So you can actually go and make these final adjustments afterwards. So you can notice, like, just even changing from here to there totally changes the person that we're looking at. You know, it's really quite amazing. And let's make them a little bit more narrow. There we go. And now we're going to click OK. So we're going to apply this. So if you want to see the difference, this is before and this is after. So you can see you can literally change a person into somebody else. So this is something that can be used for good or for evil. So let's go have a look here, and I'm just going to show you some presets that I just quickly made. So let's have a look at this photo working with presets. So what we're going to do is we're going to choose the filter liquify. And here's the shot that I've got there. Notice the eyes and everything are all picked up. It's a lot of fun. So what we're going to do is we're going to choose load mesh. And you'll find that these meshes, well, I've saved them under my creative cloud file. So let's start with, Jennifer Aniston. Obviously, it's not going to look exactly like her, but it has a little bit more. We're going to choose a Megan Fox. We could choose a Olivia Wilde, you know, with the cat eyes. And, we could also go here. We could create a silly mesh right there. So I actually happen to know someone that looks like that. So anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to reset, and I'm going to show you how to create that preset. So why don't we just go for something really interesting here. Let's go just for a tiny little eyes here. Let's go for very high height, very low. Let's go for very wide. We'll go for like really weirdly tilted, really far apart. Let's just do something really funny. So we're going to make the nose like really small. Let's do like the pixie thing here. Let's make the nose small. Let's make the width very tiny. And then the smile, give her a little bit of a smile. I love that. That's just so funny. So we're not going to smile here. We're going to make the upper lip smaller. We're going to make the lower lip bigger. There we go. And I see a lot of this when they do the collagen injections in the lips. And you say, actually, this would be good for pre-visualizing, bad plastic surgery. I know I shouldn't say that. But anyway, so we're going to make the lower lip a little bit bigger, upper lip smaller, and mouth width small because we're going to go a little more pixie. And this is fun. Watch this. Hello, how are you? So you can just go kind of silly with this. Forehead. I think pixies are going to have a bigger forehead. Chin height. Let's go for, little chin here. Jawline, thin jawline for pixies. Face width, definitely small. And then once you change the face, you might find the eyes need a little bit more adjustment. So let's just bring those eyes a little bit closer together. And what we're going to do is we're going to choose to save this mesh. Pixie. Boom. And we've saved it and click OK. And actually, if we want to have a look at this, by the way, before and after, you can see it's quite a big difference. So if you wanted to go here and maybe apply it to this person, you could. It's going to look different, though, because it's starting with different facial features. Let me just make sure I revert to this without any changes. Now we're going to go to the filter. We're going to choose the liquify filter here. And just to show you how these presets will come from one to the other, load the mesh, and we could grab our pixie, which of course is going to look silly, but let's do it anyway, and click right there. And you can see how you can grab one and apply it. All right, so as you can see, this face aware liquify could be a dangerous tool or a weapon in the wrong hands, but it's a heck of a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more tutorials like this, become a Cafe Crew member, hit that subscribe button right now, and I'll have new tutorials to you every single week. So until then, don't forget, add a comment, hit the like button, and until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.